Carcinoid syndrome is a complication of neuroendocrine tumors, which mostly occur in some parts of the gut or in the lungs. These cancers can secrete substances like serotonin and histamine, causing a constellation of symptoms that I remember with the rhyme squeeze, wheeze, flush, and feces. This reminds me that the syndrome often causes issues with our squeezing heart. It can present with a persistent respiratory wheeze, as well as skin flushing and diarrhea. Now, neuroendocrine tumors come from cells that normally function as a part of both the nervous and endocrine system. They respond to signaling neurons by releasing things like serotonin into the blood. As most of these tumors occur in the gut, the secretions usually enter the portal venous system. Now, this is really important because they would typically get metabolized by the liver. Here, serotonin gets converted into inactivated versions, 5-hydroxyindoleacetic acid, or 5-HIAA. This is then excreted into the urine, just so you can conveniently send it to a lab as a quick way to investigate carcinoid syndrome. Now, to rationalize the clinical features in carcinoid syndrome, let's imagine the neuroendocrine tumor has metastasized somewhere like the liver, or maybe it's just started in the lungs. These secretions wouldn't get metabolized, meaning they would start to work their bad magic while acting as hormonally active substances. Serotonin stimulates intestinal secretions and increases motility. That's why most people would get diarrhea. It also stimulates fibrosis, which can lead to cardiac valvular issues. Don't forget, neuroendocrine tumors also produce other substances like histamine, which causes vasodilation and pruritus. This is why people often get facial flushing. Finally, these cancers often produce prostaglandins, which might explain a patient's wheeze. To investigate for carcinoid syndrome, think about bedside tests, bloods, and imaging. At the bedside, a urinary 5-HIAA can be performed. This is usually a 24-hour collection and would usually be high in carcinoid syndrome. In reality, blood tests are often unhelpful. For example, serotonin concentrations are not routinely recommended as false positives are frequent. However, UECs and CMPs are great to screen for electrolyte imbalances from the diarrhea. A number of imaging tests are also available to help you detect for metastatic lesions. In particular, somatostatin receptor scintigraphy is a great investigation. Somatostatin is an inhibitory hormone that binds to neuroendocrine tumors, telling them to switch off production. Now, this is great because it helps us identify the location of tumors and gives us a great way to treat the syndrome. On that note, let's discuss its management with a mnemonic at the end. Firstly, if the cancer is surgically resectable, then you can just cut it out with curative intent. However, neuroendocrine tumors are mostly metastatic, which means this is often not an option. Symptomatic management can be achieved with the drug octreotide, which is a somatostatin analog. Similarly, interferon alpha is another drug that not only decreases symptoms, but also has an anti-proliferative effect. Finally, chemotherapy can help to decrease tumor burden, but often is minimally effective for symptoms. My mnemonic to remember all of this is the carcinoid COMIC. This stands for CUT, O for octreotide and M management, I for interferon alpha, and C for chemotherapy. Thanks for watching Townsend Teachings.